art and let the whole world know that we are people of the book. If you have a Bible, if you want to hold up your Bible, repeat after me, this is the Holy Bible.
This is the Holy Bible.
It is the inerrant Word of God.
It is the inerrant Word of God.
It is a lamp to my feet.
It is a lamp to my feet.
A light along my pathway.
A light along my
pathway.
I am saved.
To the book of Judges, to the book of Judges, the 7th chapter. This is our send-off Sunday. And we're thankful to our parent advisory ministry team who coordinates these special days every school year. And I want young folk to know, and older folk as well, as we move to new heights, that wherever you go, just remember to take the Lord with you.
Amen.
Amen. And if you do that, we know that well will be your situation. Judges, the 7th chapter, verse number 4. We shall read that one verse and then leap from that verse into our lesson. When you have it, just say amen.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible, the Word of God reads, "And the Lord said unto Gideon, the people are yet too many. Bring them down unto the water, and I will try them for thee there. And it shall be that of whom I say, this shall go with thee, the same shall go with thee. And of whomsoever I say unto thee, this shall not go with thee,
the same shall not go with thee."
If you would, repeat after me. Six things that
every Christian
needs in their backpack. Turn to the nearby neighbor who doesn't look too mean and say, "Neighbor,
make sure
that you have the necessary items as you march out to war." You may take your seats in the house of God. Amen, somebody. Amen. Amen. Six things. I want to preach about six things that every Christian needs to have in their backpack. I'm going to give you three this morning and three on tonight. And for those who know their preacher, the church said amen.
Amen.
I'm not going to be like Pharaoh. I'm going to let God's people go. Amen. Six things you need in your backpack. If you are a child of God, there are some things that you need to make sure you have in your backpack. This being the preparation month for returning to school, we are quite familiar with the shopping scene of how parents and guardians are rushing to stores to fill the requests that are made by certain schools and school districts that require students to come to class with certain necessary mandatory supplies that would provide enrichment in their learning process. I'm so thankful that when we go to these supermarkets, we can see families coming together and mothers especially running from aisle to aisle, picking up various supplies because they have some school-age children. Perhaps they have even grown children, but they want to make sure that their child is adequately and properly prepared. No parent that's a good parent will send their child to school not being prepared for the task at hand. Even a parent who may not be able to afford will even ask, and sometimes it may be begged, because you don't want the attention to be on your child not being properly prepared for the first day of school. We save money, budget money, but perhaps we don't save, we just budget. Amen, somebody. But we put money aside to purchase supplies to be certain that we give our child everything they need so that the learning process will be one that will enrich their life. Well, help me lift that thought a little higher. If every parent who loves their child thinks enough of their child, makes sure that every child they have, every child that wears their name, makes sure that they have the supplies and the items necessary to walk into that classroom and to get the best grade possible. How much more do we have a God in heaven, hallelujah somebody, who is our heavenly Father, who owns the deed to our souls, who should be the guardian of our lives? How much more prepared should we be in the realm of life itself? You see, what we do many times is, amen, we get the things that we want, and we beg for the stuff that we need. Y'all are quiet. Amen. Somebody help me preach. I need some folk that were real like I was real. Now, where your parents told you, take care of your responsibilities, take care of your, amen, mandatory compulsory. MC. So pop quiz it. You have paid for this, but because God had prepared you, you came out with a passing grade. Amen. Yeah. Because you do know that life will throw up pop quizzes every day.
Send you back without knowing the Lord.
Yes.
Every student needs to know the Lord.
Amen.
We teach them arithmetic. We teach them how to read. We teach them how to write. We teach them how to speak. Amen. Praise God. They know how to play these video games. They know how to work these cellular tablets, phones, computers, laptops, and etc. But we need somebody in here that knows how to work this Bible. Y'all getting quiet here. We need some young folk that know how to work this Bible. And don't tell me young folk can't learn it. Y'all getting quiet. I wish I had some folk that would preach with me today. If we can learn the stuff we're interested in, then that means that we just need to redirect our interest toward this book called the Bible, and somebody in here needs to know the law. Oh, you need to know the law. You need to be able to work these pages. I mean, you need to know Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. You need to know Acts and Rome. You need to know something about this book, because here it is. Shall come. And if you haven't got your lesson, if you haven't got your homework, and you know what? It takes us as parents. Amen. You see, I can't expect my children to know more about the Lord than I do. But many times that's the case in the world, but it should not be that way. We need to know the Lord for ourselves. Amen. And then we need to share our Lord with our children. I remember, I wish I had people that grew up like I grew up. Bro, they used to pray. And folk used to pray, and I'm not saying you have to do it like they did. I'm just saying you knew what they were going to say. Lord, here I come before you. Knee bent, body bowed. I thank you, Lord, for waking me up this morning and for starting me on my way. Lord, I thank you for last night's lying down, this morning's early rising. I thank you, Lord, that my covers did not become my winding sheets. I got to have this one has some folk to do it right now. Lord, I thank you because I know that it was nobody but you that brought us over. But Lord, I don't know what's on the other side, but I know who holds tomorrow. And I know who holds my hand. You see, the folk back in the day reverenced God. And we have to have that same mentality if we're going to make it in this world today. People need to know the Lord. And it's when you know the Lord, there's just some things you're not willing to do. It's not that you're better than anyone. It's not that you're smarter than anyone. It's not that you have a better standard of living per se, but you have principles. Here it is, you have standards. Here it is, you have expectations. There were just some things that we would not dare do. We're losing that kind of respect. And I'm going to tell you that old school not always bad. Amen. Some of the best teaching is old teaching. You're going to make me go to that book. I believe in Jeremiah the 6th chapter. God told them to stand me in the old. Children young people, you can be anything you want to be. You put your mind to it. You can be anything you want to be. And if you look around in this church, we have all kinds of professional and skilled people. Amen. And you can do anything you want to do. Don't you let anybody discourage you from your dream. Amen. But you make sure that your dream honors the Lord. Don't talk to me against somebody. You see, you have to make this good a dream. Everybody should have dreams. But make sure that your dream is about honoring God. Because you can dream something that doesn't give God glory. And why would God bless something if you don't have it in it? Someone said, well, I don't want to get into that. But the point is, make sure that you tap the Lord with you. And then the next thing I see in the text is you need the word. You need the word. See, the word enables you to know the Lord. The reason folk don't know the Lord is because we don't know the word. You see, when you become one with the word, then you get to learn about the Lord. And you don't need anybody else to teach you about the Lord if they're not coming from the Word. The psalmist says, thy Word is a lamp unto my feet and a light along my pathway. Do you know what a light provides? A light will illuminate the path. It brightens it up. It enables you to see where you're going. And without a light turned on, you'll be bumping into everything. Over stuff. And there's some stuff in life you don't have to trip over if you turn the light on. You don't miss a step. Yeah, we all have missed steps. As a matter of fact, raise your hand if you're older. Well, raise your hand if you're above 20 and you've ever made a mistake. Just raise your hand. You see young folk, you see older folk, you've been asked about messing up. No, y'all gonna say that. Yeah, we are professional mess uppers. We can tell you a thing or two about messing up. You don't have to make the same mess up. Look at all these folks in here that know about messing up. Just ask somebody. The lamp to your feet. Light. Along your pathway, there's some things, and if I listen to this, if I listen to this good book, it'll keep me out of some sticky situations. Talk to me and hear somebody. And then sometimes, you know, you can be well-versed. That doesn't mean you always gonna listen. Oh, I wish I had some honest folk in here with me. It's in front of a preacher, that's me. I know it. Third thing you need. Are you there, Brother Lewis? Let's read Judges 7, verse number 15. Let me show him that I'm serious about closing. And it was so. The Bible says that it was so. When Gideon heard the telling of the dream,
here it is,
and the interpretation thereof, that he worshiped.
That's it. That he did what?
That he worshiped.
That he worshiped. Now, Gideon, before he went out to battle, he knew that he needed the Lord. He knew that he needed the Lord. You want the Lord to advance ahead of you. See, you don't want to go into a situation and the Lord follow you. You are going out there first. And then you come back and say, well, now I'm going to ask, what did God say? Well, you done messed up now. You see what I'm saying? It's going to take a lot more medicine to deal with your sickness. Amen. But you want the Lord to go be. So Gideon knew that if we're going to win this battle, we need the Lord. And then we need his word. Because watch, just like a good parent
should leave it up to their child to pat them on the back. Because children are not going to do what they should have done. Right? So it takes the parent to make sure you got to check behind. The Lord has to check behind. Let the Lord tell you what to put in your back. Lord said, you need me, but you need my word. Got my word with you, again.
Yes,
and whoever I tell you is worthy, that's who you need. And whoever I tell you to leave, you need them where you find them. Oh, Lord, that's a sermon right there. And I learned it like just some folk. Amen. And the Lord showed me a long time ago. But what happened, I picked them up, and I carried them from one season into another. Some folk just for one season, man. And you can't make a permanent thing y'all require, whatever. But I know folk need to know that. See, and I'm going to tell you something. I know folk really know this. Because, see, you can fall in love for a season. Is that all right? I need some grandmas in here.
Knew it was important.
fellowship with the Lord. So he humbled himself and he worshiped God. And then he rose up like a man when I came to start. Young folk, older folk, all of us, we send off Sunday. Let's make sure that the Christians that go to the next semester go into the semester with everything they need in their backpack. When you have what you need in your spiritual backpack, there are going to be some tests. There are going to be some quizzes. There may even be some mistakes made along the way. But at least you have what you need. Amen. To make the journey. Stand to your feet. Someone say yes to Jesus. You need to believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. Be willing to repent of all of his sins. Understanding that I can make the confession before me and with my mouth that Jesus Christ is the only Savior in time. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess. And I understand that when I say yes to Jesus, repenting of my sins, turning away from what I used to do, walking with the Lord, I'm ready to be baptized for the remission of my sins. And I want to be baptized because Jesus said, get in the water. Matthew, the third chapter, suffer it to be so, to fulfill all righteousness. Jesus went into the water to show us how to go into the water and to be added to the family of God. Jesus Christ went up to the hill, the skull-shaped place called Golgotha. There they crucified him for you and for me. But I'm so thankful that the Lord God was in the plan. He had already packed Jesus' backpack. Jesus understood that he came to die. He wasn't like most of us. He didn't come here to live. He came here to die. But he knew that he would be buried, but that he would rise again on the third day. Hallelujah. Amen. And he's alive now forevermore. Yes. And if you want to be saved, you must hear that gospel claim and come to Jesus just as you are. If you're already part of the body of Christ, you need to rededicate your soul. Now is the acceptable time. But whatever you do, do not leave here without being on the Lord's side. Will you come as we sing the song of the Lord?